What's up, y'all? It's your rough line. It's Queen Cash here for Black City TV, your one-stop source for music, fashion, entertainment, and lifestyle. Right now, we're going to get into our episode with Black City TV's Top 5 Music Video Countdown. Let's go.
There I go, 2 clicks more for the Bronx. Whoever thought she would have found love in a stereo? 2 headphones in a box. She picks me up every morning on the walk to school. She ain't worried about these other little kids. She told me every day you say something new, and you always got the illest kids. Boom, boom. 10, and she takes me out just so the block can see. Told me she wanted the world to know, so she makes me loud. Now the whole block wants me, but I'm all hers, and she's all mine. And even though her parents don't like me inside, whenever her daddy comes around, we just hide. Cause she doesn't want to sleep without me, that's why I said.
So tell me. Forget about the world being young tonight. I'm coming for ya, I'm coming for ya. Cause all I need is a beauty and a beat who can make my life complete. It's all about you when the music makes you move. You away from me, but now I'm just coming back like a fiend. You went from a slide to a friend and a lover, now you're everything. Trying to lie and tell myself that you ain't anything, but I'm in your bed with my phone off. Should be out the door, but I doze off when I know I should be leaving. But I can't control how I'm feeling.
Down them trees, I'm out the door with that drone and them keys. Scooping up Chris and I'm hitting the freeway. Yeah, got a whole zip of that perk. Got a couple hoes home with no clothes on. Get a roll on, let's twerk. Now we hotboxing that ghost. Ace all in that dough. Ray-Bans on my face. Never know when my eyes low. Smoke good, fuck good. Eat good, stay cow. She said backwoods, kill switches. You eat, take out. Yeah. But I love fucking in red bone. She country thick and that hair long. That pussy killer, she dead wrong. She with me.
I can feel you now. Keep on doing the same old thing, and you expecting change. Well, is that really insanity, or just a loser's game? I only trust in the things I feel. Some may say that.
In tech news today, we're going to be talking about the new Kindle Fire HD that drops this November with lots of new features. Let's check it out. Sitting here with the lovely Tiffany Tattoos. Hey girl.
Hey.
How you doing today? Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
Absolutely. So we're just going to get right to it. How long have you been tattooing?
I've been tattooing for almost 4 years now.
Okay, so not that long, but not enough experience because I've seen your work and it's totally excellent.
Thank you.
Like off the hook. You got me wanting another tattoo now. We'll talk about that off camera.
Okay.
Right. Yeah. I also read though that you started drawing when you were 2 years old. Is that true?
Yes, it is true.
What's your earliest memory of drawing something? What do you remember?
Honestly, I really just remember coloring a lot in coloring books. I always wanted coloring books, always doing that. But my parents told me at 2 years old, I was actually drawing things. And at 2 years old, you're just scribbling, you know.
That's exactly what impressed me. Like,
yeah, and I was already drawing at 2 years old. So they always brought that to my attention as one of the memories they remember.
Yeah.
Me being young as an artist. So.
Absolutely. And I see that your dad is part of why you tattoo now, because he bought you your first kit.
He bought me my first tattoo machine.
Wow, that's like awesome.
It's different. It's different.
Exactly. That's
a parent buying you a tattoo machine is just, you don't really hear that much.
But I see that you took it and you ran with it, because definitely. This is what you do now, right?
Yes.
Do you have any tattoos?
I have three.
Any that you can show?
Yes, I have this one in my arm. It's my first tattoo. It says God's image is the biblical meaning of my name. So.
Okay.
That's probably the only visible one.
All right, nice. Do you plan on getting more?
I do.
A lot more, or are you not?
Not really a lot more. I'm just more into the craft rather than getting them, but I do have some plans for what I want to do. But of course, they'll be a little hidden as well.
Okay, I hear that. So I also had the opportunity online to see that you've had the experience of tattooing celebrities. And how did that come about, especially with Omarion? Like, where did that come from?
He actually contacted me on Twitter. He saw a picture that I posted up. And then he wrote me a message. And then we kind of went back and forth through email. And he tried to find out where I was, because he was in L.A. or something like that. Yeah. And then I told him I was here in New Jersey. And he was like, well, you know, if I ever come down that way to, like, New York, I'll definitely hit you up. And a few months later, he did hit me up. He wrote me a message. He's like, Tiff, I'm out here. So we worked that out, and I ended up tattooing him.
Nice. Very cool. I was like, really? Okay. And that's cool that he kept his word, because, you know, people can tell you anything.
Yeah,
because
when he told me, well, I'll let you know, I was like, he's never going to hit me up. But he ended up contacting me.
So Tiffany, you're currently working out of New Jersey, is that correct? What part of New Jersey?
North New Jersey.
And what's the name of the tattoo parlor?
It's called Writer's Ink.
All right. How is it working there? How is it working at a tattoo parlor?
It's kind of just, I really don't know how to answer
it. No, is it like what I see on TV? Because there's a few, more than a few tattoo shows out there right now.
Yeah, no. When I first started working, we had a different crew of artists, and they were very extra.
Okay.
So there was always something happening, and it was kind of like the way it was on TV. Okay. But now we have, like, very quiet artists. We all mind our business, just work, and, you know, I'm just really focused now here. And it's at the shop, it's not wild and crazy like it used to be.
Okay, fair enough. What do you consider, like, a difficult tattoo patron, like someone who comes in and maybe has no idea what they want? Like, can you come up with something for that person?
I can, but it is difficult. When someone comes in and they have no idea what they want done, it's kind of hard for me, because they'll say, do whatever you want, but my style might be different from yours, or I might draw something and you might not even like it. I kind of need at least one idea to work off of, because to me that idea is my inspiration.
Okay.
So if they have no idea what to do, then it's kind of like, okay, where do I start? So it makes it a little difficult.
All right. Okay, so I'm going to put you on the spot. Not really, really, but a little bit. Okay. So, you know, we just spoke about having a difficult person, or not even difficult, but just an undecided person come to the tattoo parlor.
Okay.
If I were that difficult person, what might you come up with for me?
Ooh, that is a good question.
I know we've only known each other 10 minutes, but just let me know what your artist mind sees and where you might go with it.
Oh, that's tough. Maybe possibly some type of symbol.
Okay.
But I would have to kind of ask you questions, like, about yourself in order for me to kind of see which direction I want to go with this symbol. All
right.
And something feminine, of course. And I don't know. I like to do things that kind of flow and have, like, negative space in there, where it's like things are shaded on the outside and the inside is your skin tone color.
Okay.
Because I think it has a cool effect. So I'll probably do something like that. But I would just have to ask you a little bit more questions about you as a person.
All right, fair enough. Well, I do want to tattoo in the near future, so, you know.
Let me know.
All right, I'll hit you up, girl. Speaking of, if I can hit you up, what are, like, some of the contacts? Let people know where they can find you.
Definitely my website, tiffanytattoos.com, tattoos with a Z. That has everything you need to know, my hours, my address, my email address. My email address is simple2tiffanytattoos@gmail.com. Okay. Twitter, it's Tats by Tiff. And Instagram, which is the new hot thing, Tiffany Tattoos. I'm always on Instagram, so that's a good way to...
Well, good, because we want to see more of your work. Yes. Like I said, you're so talented. I can't wait to see what you have to come up with in the future. What are some of your short-term goals for yourself?
Definitely open up a new tattoo parlor, private studio for myself.
Okay.
And then just travel a lot, do a lot of conventions, get my name out there, and just get this reputation that I want as like a very, very good tattoo artist, female tattoo artist.
You are well on your way, let me just say. I campaign for you. I'll let folks know that you're available, you're good, and the best way to do that is to advertise myself. So we'll be in touch.
Okay.
I'm thinking about something back here. I know you'll hook me up.
All right.
Thank you so much for stopping by Black City TV today. We appreciate you, and that's how we're going to sign off. Y'all wave bye to the camera.
Well, peoples, that does it for this episode of Black City TV. Please make sure you log on to blackcitymag.com and check us out. Till next time, Queen Cash, I'm signing off. Peace.